The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Thank you and welcome to It's a Family Affair. Usually for you listeners who know our show, usually we're playing Sly and the Family Stone. It's a Family Affair. But today we are honoring our mothers on the show, and it's Mother's Day weekend. It's Friday. I am one of your hosts, Kathleen Bradley, Red, R-E-D-D. And a.k.a. Miss Parker, Miss Parker. And I'm very happy to be here today. So we're going to have a fun day. And this show is Yo Momma, or I'll Always Love My Momma. We're going to mix it up a little bit with a few little jokes and a little sentiment, little surprises and a few things. So first of all, I want to really thank everybody for watching, checking in, telling your friends, telling your family. We're coming to you live right now. And if you miss it, that's the beauty of this show. You can always go to the YouTube with RMC Live. Within 24 hours, they'll have the show back up. And we also have our website, and it's www.itsafamilyaffair.biz, like showbiz. Because we is in showbiz, people. We's in showbiz, and we some showbiz family here. Okay, so I'm going to, without any further ado, introduce you to my dear, sweet, lovely, wonderful husband, Mr. Terrence Redd. Hey, baby.
Whoop, 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 bringing it live to you, all the husbands. Okay, we're here, Family Affair. Thanks for tuning in. Anyway, let's extend a good, warm thank you for everyone who's actually responded by email and actually looked at these Big T's energy tips, who were trying to bring value and save dollars in your pocket. Well, we got some more surprises for you and a lot of fun today. It's going to be a good, good Mother's Day show. So anyway, you know, we had a family member that wasn't here last time, and we got her now. So let me make sure you all know. We got here Cheyenne, you're back. The Kardashian killer in full effect.
A double K.
Bring it on home.
Hey, hey, hey.
How you doing?
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. Me, at least that is. Welcome me back. Thank you all for tuning in. Thank you all for the love and support. I'm Cheyenne, the oldest of my mother. Happy Mother's Day in advance, Mommy. Love you.
Thank you, sweetie.
Love you to all you wonderful mothers out there. my other mommy, Jane, all my other mothers, mommy Lynn, my godmother, Renee and Elaine, Auntie Terry, all my mommies in Ohio, Shimmy, Danielle, who else? Just all whoever's watching, I appreciate you for watching. I want to give you some love, 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 and tell you to have a wonderful and blessed Mother's Day. Support and call your mama. Tell her you love her and miss her. You kiss her, whatever, whatever you want to tell her. I also want to thank our sponsor, the lovely Chambord, a black raspberry flavored vodka.
I'll drink to that.
Which Mumsy is already having a little swig of, having a sample. We definitely, definitely want to thank our sponsor. Been very supportive. So be sure to go out and grab some Chambord and look up online. They have some lovely cocktails, and tune in for the drink of the week with Shaking It Up with Cheyenne. And I'll be mixing up some wonderful cocktails for you all also. I'd like to now pass it over to my little bro T, Mr. Beatmaster, T Red.
My baby. T Red. Well, it's about to be Mother's Day this Sunday, and I'm glad to be with my family. I'm glad to see my mother still kicking, still making moves, still doing what she has to do, still making her book coming out soon, Backstage at the Price is Right. Yeah. And it's been an honor and a very great opportunity to be on this radio show, because we get to share all our family trials and tribulations and ups and downs and everything that we can give from our experience to all the families out there. And we have some good feedback, and I'm glad that we have some fans already that are giving us love and support. And just keep tuning in, keep watching, keep logging on, go on to the website, itsafamilyaffair.biz. so we got a lot coming in the future. Next week I should be able to show everybody how to do some engineering tips on for music, what equipment to use, what not to use, what programs to use, and what to look for when you're doing your business and your marketing. So, we have a lot of things to give out to the folks that's trying to make it out there. So, we're going to have a great show maybe some prizes, too.
Okay.
So without further ado, my cousin, a.k.a. Nephew Narayana Ji, is coming to us live from Columbus, Ohio today. Hey. He's there visiting his family. Shout outs to Ohio. Hey, Narayan, how's it going?
Hey, Narayan.
Everything is great.
We missed you. We're missing you, man.
I'm out here in Ohio.
Yeah.
How you doing out there? You're not sitting in the corner shaking from the weather, right? Everything nice and warm.
Come on now. I'm keeping it moving. I'm representing them engineers. You know how we do.
Okay,
I'm
good.
Just putting together a constant flow, a contingency plan of getting it. You know how we get it.
Yes, you are the spiritual master, all master leader. Ryan G. He is center G. We should call you Center G. Ryan G.
I just want to say, I'm personally offended. Y'all didn't call me when I was out of town handling business. I was available to talk, too. I'm offended.
Well, I think you were in the air heading for...
You was in flight.
No. I landed right on time, and the week before that, I wasn't even on a plane, so you all could have called me.
And you have the number. You know that's called
calling in.
Hello.
You personally called. Okay, I'm bringing it up.
We have this plan. I don't know what you were doing, honey.
I think that Schomburg is kicking in, man.
I'm offended because you guys didn't plan to call me. You planned to call Narayan. You took time out of the day. You text messaged him and everything.
Yeah, well, you know what, Narayan, not that you haven't, but I must say, Narayan has been so instrumental in really helping with the special commercials that we shoot every week for Spectrum Contractors. He's been instrumental in shooting the commercials that you do. We made sure you were represented.
Well, who else was instrumental? Who's the other instrument in the commercial? Well,
he's doing it and putting it together, editing, doing the music. He is a master of many. You know, I can't say a master of none, but he's a master of many, and we love him and appreciate that. So he's far away.
And, I love you.
Know, he's going to be back. He's going to be rain on your parade. I'm just hating. I'm just hating on the game, not the player. Don't trip.
But he's gonna be gone for 4 weeks. So we are a troop here and well joined at the hip. So we want to make sure at all times everyone is represented, whether they're gone or not, whether they're in a video or not. So We right. won't. We Thank don't want to miss anybody. People don't want to miss anybody. Okay, hey, you know what?
Plus, hold on. Plus, I have some special video coming too.
Oh.
With my brother, he's a bodybuilder, fitness trainer, and he's the first black vegetarian bodybuilder that won first place all natural. So
what?
I got him coming next show, if possible. And I'm going to do an interview with him and put him on the map because he's very exclusive.
Yes, nice. He is. Wow, that's wonderful. I saw Mark
that
and
body,
Dale.
That body is exclusive, Mark and Dale. Woo!
Scary.
I'm working on my guns right now. I
black
got
Arnold
it
Schwarzenegger.
He is the black Arnold Schwarzenegger. But he's like the black. He looks like Timok. Last Dragon.
Yeah. No, he's more. No. Oh,
Bruce,
you're talking
Bruce
about
Leroy.
His face.
Bruce
Leroy.
He has the look with the face, but
he's
never...
finer than him. But he reminds me of him. But he's much more built. Yeah. Oh. Mark and Dez.
It's unbelievable. Sometimes I think some of those muscles are a little scary.
What do they used to say? You go pop a cherry with your ass.
Oh wow!
I never heard that one, but I know we can pop something else with something else we got between our legs too. Hello, pop
I don't
that.
Think Ooh, I don't think they vote for weightlifters on popping cherries with their cheeks like that.
That's how tight their booties are. I'm just saying those gluteus minimums and maximus and in between. Trust me, I know about those glute muscles. And especially that gluten free muscle.
Anyways, we're gonna keep it in between the show.
Yeah. You know? Okay. You know what? Hey, listen. Let's get back to. We got a little. We have to stay with a little format here, folks, because our family is a little out there. We can get a little outrageous and start talking in tangents. So I have to print up every week a very nice little format that we have to abide by. But it is Mother's Day weekend. Like I said, we'll be saying and telling some jokes, your mama jokes and what have you, and having some things going on. And actually, I have a joke.
Surprise! Before your joke, we want to start you off with some flowers. At least you can sit up here with some flowers and have some beauty in your face.
Oh, wow.
happy pre-Mother's Day.
You got a quick one in there.
Happy Mother's Day.
Damn
it. You know, I love to be surprised, and I get pissed off when I'm surprised because I think I should know every damn thing.
Oh, well, here's some flowers. I don't have a flower in a vase, but you can put them right here so everybody can see your lovely flowers.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah.
No, that is not from them. That is personal. No, I'm just kidding.
that's
from all of us. But.
Just to show you, we can even cut a diva at the knees, baby. We can bring you down.
I think I have to put it down here because I don't want to. I'm going to put it on my left. No, but you're going to be
safe.
Happy Mother's Day.
Clouding your... vision, or people's vision. Okay, anyway, you know what? Thank you, guys. I appreciate that. I love flowers. Mm-hmm. And anyway, right now, you know what? Let me tell a joke. I meant to bring a photo of my mother, my dearly departed, lovely mother, Terrence's mother-in-law, who she just loved and adored, and Cheyenne and T's mother, grandmother, and Narayan's grandmother, actually. There's a joke I always remember, this one in particular, that my mother would tell me, and it goes a little something like this. This old lady was walking down the street, just minding her own business, and walking down the street. All of a sudden, this man ran up on her and accosted her. He had a gun. He said, "Lady, give me all your money. Give me your money right now. I know where you keep your money. Give me your money." She said, "Oh, sonny, I ain't got no money. I ain't got no cash. I ain't got no money on me." He said, "I know you do. I know where you keep your money." So he started filling up on her breast and stuff, trying to see if she got some money up in there and everything. He said, "Oh, shoot." She said, "I told you I had no money." He said, "I know you got some money somewhere." He started filling her up down below and everything and trying to check in her pantyhose and filling up all up in her stuff. He said, "Damn, you don't have no money. What am I wasting my time with you for? You don't have no cash. You ain't got no money." She said, "Sonny, I told you I don't have no cash money. I don't have no money." She said, "But I tell you one thing. You do that again, I'll write you a check."
She said, "You keep feeling around and then I'll write you a check.
Do that again, I'll write you a check." That was one of my mother's favorites.
That joke was
that's
hilarious.
That's an old school joke.
You know, my mother would tell those kind of jokes, though a little edgy, and I would take her with me, you know, to parties and celebrity outings and different events, and they loved her. I would be looking for my mom, wondering where she is. She would be holding court with the men and some women in a circle around her, telling these jokes, cracking up there, cracking up laughing, just having a wonderful time. That's what kind of spirit my mom had. Such a wonderful lady.
And what did she used to say about what people would call her at the studio?
What, Kathleen's mom?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Always Kathleen's mom. You know, usually I'm sure a lot of people out there, and girls and women and kids and families have, that's Terrence's mom. That's Cindy's mom. You know, hey, this is my mom. Like, you don't introduce them with names, but it's Winifred Ann Bradley. Come on down.
She broke the mold for mother-in-law. She was definitely a wonderful, beautiful woman.
Yeah, she did. She loved her some Terrence.
Absolutely.
So,
yeah.
You know. Wow. Hey, time is slipping away. I think we're really due for a little commercial here. What's going on? Anybody know what's going on except me here? Ah, Cheyenne. Not paying attention as usual.
What is that?
And you even made it here
you
on time.
Still talking.
I'm
that
surprised.
Is not even on me.
Mm-hmm. It's 7:45. No, I mean 6:45. You know,
shot.
In the middle here. Oh, what do we have?
What is it? Shaking up with Chambord?
Is it shaking up with Chambord?
Shaking
time?
It up with Chambord. It's time to quench your thirst, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to show you the Chambord Martini. So please stay tuned for the commercial. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Shaking It Up with Cheyenne with your drink of the week. Sponsored by Chambord, a French black raspberry flavored vodka. This week, we're going to show you how to make the French Sparkle, which is 1.5 ounces of Chambord. Mango puree, and you're just going to put about 1 ounce of your mango puree right at the bottom of your cup because you don't want to get your strainer all clogged. So we're going to shake up our Chambord. We're shaking it with Cheyenne, of course. Simply strain and pour over your mango and pour in your champagne for the sparkle. You can add whatever type of garnish you like. I like to use strawberry. Generally, you would use a black raspberry for your black raspberry flavored vodka. And enjoy. Cheers. Next week, we'll have another wonderful beverage for you. Please make sure you tune in. See you later. Thanks for shaking it up with Cheyenne, sponsored by Chambord.
Well, we got a little news between Kobe and his mama, you know, Pamela Bryant. Kobe Bryant, that's my boy. Hopefully he gets his recovery back soon. He'll be back next season. I'm telling you, don't lose hope. We'll be getting that other ring. Get your Achilles heel therapy right. See you next season, Kobe. But anyways, he actually filed a case against his mother, Pamela Bryant, because she was actually selling his memorabilia, everything.
Shirts, T-shirts,
his
rings.
Whole T-shirts, his awards, his rings, his jerseys to be auctioned off. So she actually partnered up with Golden Auctions, which is in New Jersey. She basically received $450,000. For selling a couple things already.
Think she's going to be in a little trouble if she already spent some money.
I know. She might be, but she actually wanted to put that money towards a new home in Nevada. So, you know, in
the basic, back, huh?
Right. And basically, Kobe Bryant is filing a case against her because she did this without his permission.
Right.
And this is his belongings. You know, this, you can't just. You know, mom, you ain't gonna go in my room and say, you want this old basketball still? Like, you know, you're gonna ask me before you wanna put some stuff in a garage sale, right?
So, right.
He's supposed to ask you, that's right.
Right.
Hey there.
But, you know, anyways, it's just weird that she would do all that without even asking him. And she basically has all this stuff in a New Jersey storage unit that costs $1,500 per month. And basically,
a house note, man.
Yeah, I know, it is.
That's what she said. $1,500 a month. That is a lot of money. First of all,
to keep his stuff in storage.
It's a lot of money for a storage unit. Period. We're here in California, and I know people who have pretty reasonably sized storage units that only pay like $350 a month. Right. And if you could see what she was auctioning off, there's no way that amount, that size and volume of what she's auctioning off. She didn't pay $1,500.
Well, you add that $1,500 to the house note she's already paying, and there's her big house that she wants that she's trying to go spend cash on. How can you spend $1,500 a month on a storage spot? You can get a lot of square footage in Vegas.
Well, you know what?
Well, this is Kobe Bryant and this Pamela Bryant we're talking about. They can do anything.
Say what, Narayana? What is your feedback on this? What do you think?
Well, I think it's a lot of. He say, she say, we really don't know what really happened, though.
Yeah, we do.
No. He could have said, Mom, go ahead, auction it off. I'm just saying,
Narayana, stop being so naive. He did not say, Mama, auction it off. Here's what happens.
I'm just saying, he said, auction it off.
Even if he said, Mama, you keep it. Or take it. I don't care about it. Here's what was said,
He said, I don't care about it. It was locked in the garage, collecting dust.
Yeah, he said, I didn't really care about it.
I can make some money off it.
At that time, because he's moving forth with his wife and family and kids and doing his thing, and probably she asked him at an unopportune time where he was probably not even thinking about it.
So that's personal then. That's on him. Then
I feel the same
way. No, I don't feel that at all.
In a way.
No. It's no. It's not.
Wait. Let him say it. Let him talk.
If he said that, then it's on him.
But he never really legally. I have stuff from all of my children at home in Hope Chest and in the garage. I had to build an extra. We had to build an extra little a storage unit on the other side of our garage at home. Hubby, I tell you, just in order to keep our kids, Dior, Cheyenne, and T's storage things. Cheyenne in particular, because she collects a lot of items. I won't say she's a rat pack.
Wait a minute. We ain't talking about Kobe. We ain't talking about
I know, but I'm saying, if it put in that position.
There be no comparison right
no,
now.
No, but let's there is no comparison. That is so right, because
what
you're
if
talking,
all Cheyenne's stuff was worth $2 million?
I would ask her before I would let her. I'd let her know prior to me auctioning it off.
Their relationship is respect. Not peachy. Their relationship is not peachy. And now it's biting her in the ass because she didn't ask him. So
yeah, she
still do. But not to say that you necessarily would. If you got frustrated with me or whatever and you were ready to get all that crap out of the side of the thing, you'd be like, I'm throwing this crap away. Even what Wendy Williams say? She said she gave away boxes of her sister's like law degree or something like that because the crap was in the garage. And everybody kept packing stuff in her garage and it was collecting dust. So she said, if it was something that important to you, why wouldn't you take better care of it or show more appreciation for it and actually have the plaques on the wall or have your jerseys in a plastic.
And why is it at his mama's house and not at his house when he got two mansions?
That's Thank
you.
True.
Well,
that's
you know
true.
What? Prior to that, he might have been moving around.
Okay, prior to that, he's a grown man.
Because that's his mama,
he's
damn it.
He's early 30s.
That's his mama. That's his mama. You'd be surprised.
Yeah, but mama, I wouldn't keep myself at my mama's house.
Please. Kobe, I got stuff from you at my lawyer. House now, boy.
Kobe's lawyer, Mark Campbell, said Mr. Bryant's personal property has ended up in the possession of someone who does not lawfully own it. So if you do not lawfully own something, then why proceed in trying to sell something without anybody else's knowledge?
Right. She did not lawfully. She did not lawfully.
It didn't just end up there.
But she didn't lawfully own it. Get it? Lawfully. That means legally. She did not own it.
Okay,
even if she left it there.
If it's at her house for a certain period of time,
it's her property.
It's not possessions. 9/10 of the law is true to some degree, but not in this case. Come on. I think that's wrong of her.
I don't understand why she didn't start a charity and auction the stuff off.
Because she was more. She went, listen. Listen to this.
That doesn't make any sense because she could have got just about equally the amount. In a way, right?
Did you hear the story that was told, though, that she wanted to buy a house in Las Vegas and that Kobe had purchased a home for his lovely wife, who he screwed around on for many years,
mom,
and did things on, and his mother-in-law, that he spent a couple million dollars on her home. Okay, therefore, the mother really got pissed off and like, well, Kobe, why are you going to spend $2 million on your mother-in-law, and I'm your mama, and you're only spending like $250,000, $400,000 on a home for me? She felt real shortchanged. Therefore, that really triggered.
Love shouldn't have a number on it, though.
Price tag, right.
Who are you telling?
Hey,
but the fact is, his mother was retaliating.
Right.
Bottom freaking line, she was retaliating because she was pissed off because she did not get the amount of money that his mother-in-law got to buy a house. So she said, I'll show his little ass who's the boss around here. I'm going to take this shit and I'm going to auction it off and I'm going to get some money for it and buy me the kind of house I want. But he's given them millions of dollars all along the way, he and her and his dad. So, you know, I don't think that's right. What do you think, husband? You're awfully quiet.
I think that Kobe is absolutely correct in the whole matter.
Right. Me too.
I think he's 100% correct. I stand
agree.
Right behind it.
Right.
Would you sell any of your children's belongings?
No. I would take it over to his house and say, you have it. I don't have room for it if I couldn't keep it. But I think Kobe's absolutely
right. That's right. I think she's going down for this. And not to mention what kind of strain that it's put on their relationship.
She's in a pickle right now.
It's been strange.
She received money.
Yeah, it's been a strange and strange. You know, they've had some ups and downs over a period of time, but absolutely this has done nothing to help repair anything that might be wrong with the...
Who's going to pay that auctioneer back his $450,000 that he paid for the items?
Credit Bureau.
I don't know. It's already happened, you know, so it's only to take this in a legal matter and see, you know, what else he can actually keep in his possession and what else she has not other... Like,
well, they actually
really
say,
done.
Okay, son, can you pay it all back and take your stuff? And I'm sorry, but I spent the money already.
No. It has to be
give me some of the money back or what'd you spend it on, you know? I tell you, it's one mess trying to keep it straight.
She ain't gonna go to the Bing, though.
And you know what?
You never know. Yeah. It is personal property, but yeah. The thing is, I understand both sides. You know, it's like I would be pissed if my mama sold or gave away. I get mad when she comes to my house and helps me clean up little stuff and starts throwing away stuff without my knowledge. I get
and much of that stuff needs to be gone away somewhere. And I'm about to sell some of your shit. Now you better come get it.
Exactly. See, it's like, you better come get it. How do we know that they didn't have the conversation of, you better come get this stuff, otherwise I'm throwing it out or I'm going to sell it?
That's irrelevant at this point in time. And the court of law is going to show
I
that.
Understand that, but I'm just saying, I, to a degree, I understand possibly why. I don't know all the intentions and the motives inside her head. If she was deceitfully getting back at him for all that drama, or if she even read that far into.
But you know what? That's true. But let's go to the lighter side of this. Do you all know that I have a will?
No, you don't.
Yes.
Do you, baby?
And I'm gonna tell you all out there, and they do know this, because last night, my kids and I, we were sitting in the living room, and I said to them, I never want to live in a vegetative state, dependent on some medicine and fluids from a bottle. And if that ever happens, just pull the plug. And they got up, unplugged the computer, and threw out the wine in my glass. Y'all little assholes. Ain't that terrible?
Oh,
I didn't
wow.
mean that literally. Look what you did. Hey, now's a good time for some Yo Momma jokes before we go to break.
Oh,
we
absolutely.
We got a good Yo Momma break.
I got a nice amount right here. Y'all going to love it.
Tell us
some old, some new. All right.
I'm going to come back at you. Let's see if you got. If I got one a little heavier, I'm going to throw it in there. Go ahead.
All right,
what you got?
All right. Your mama is so poor that she couldn't afford to pay attention.
That one is so lame.
Oh, wait.
Hold on.
Wait a minute.
I got one. Hold on.
We're going to have the battle. Your mama.
He was at school. He be getting dog.
Your mama. Here we go. Your mama's so poor. Your family ate cereal with a fork. to save milk.
Yeah.
Come on with it. Come on with it.
All right, T, your turn.
Your mama's so fat that when she talks to herself, it's like a long distance call.
Ooh. All right. Here we go. Your mama's so old, when she goes to school, there was no history class.
All right, your mama's so fat that she can't even fit into an AOL chat room.
Oh, that's cold. Okay.
Oh, wow.
You got anything else, husband? Was that it for you?
Well, I can kind of relate a little bit of energy on one, and we'll take it there. Your mama's so stupid, she bought a solar-powered flashlight.
Now, that fits right in. That fits right into your realm. Oh, my goodness.
Okay.
I got one.
Okay, Narayan.
Your mama is so fat that her belly button gets home 15 minutes before she does.
Give us some more, Narayan. Oh, you have another one?
That was good.
Was that one back from Ohio, or you learned that one out here? Where'd you get that, nephew? That's pretty good.
Hey, you guys are fat folks back there.
I got another one.
All right.
Your mama is so fat that the National Weather Service names each one of her farts.
Oh!
Oh,
Oh, Hurricane Betty, Hurricane.
Oh, wow.
Sturdy, Hurricane Farty.
Here's one. Your mama's like Sprint, 10 cents a minute anywhere in the country.
Ooh.
Was that too far or too soon?
Wait a minute. I got one. Your mama is so dark that she spits chocolate milk.
Oh, wait. Speaking of dark, your mama's so dark that she get her tattoo done in chalk.
Your mama's so dark, when she went to night school, she was marked absent.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Your mama's so fat that the light bends around her.
Oh, your mama's so fat that when she sits around the house, she sits around the house.
That's cool.
Hey, I got one long one. This was a good Mother's Day. Little,
right,
don't mess
joke.
With the mama. You know, the women be calling the shots, man. You got to be careful.
Right.
Okay. All right, a newlywed couple moves into their new house. One day, the husband comes home from work, and his wife says, "Honey, you know, in the upstairs bathroom, one of the pipes is leaking. Could you fix it?" Husband says, "What do I look like, Mr. Plumber?" A few days go by, he comes home from work, and his wife says, "Honey, the car won't start. I think it needs a new battery. Could you change it for me?" He says, "What do I look like, Mr. Goodwrench?" Another few days go by, and it's raining pretty hard. The wife finds a leak in the roof and says, "Honey, there's a leak on the roof. Can you fix it, please?" He says, "What do I look like to you, Bob Vila?" The next day, the husband comes home, and the roof is fixed. The plumbing is fixed. So is the car.
Oh.
So he asked the wife, "What happened?" She said, "Oh, I had a handyman come in and fixed him." "Great. How much is that going to cost me?" Wife says, "Nothing. He said he'd do it for free if I either baked him a cake or slept with him." "Well, what kind of cake did you make?"
Cake.
She
cake,
said,
cake,
she
cake.
Said, "What do I look like, Betty Crocker?" Don't mess with no women, son.
Oh, that's right. She did not make that cake, so you know she slept
that
with
him. That reminds me of a joke. I'm going to tell that joke later. Oh, my God.
Good stuff.
We got to take a little break right now, so... We're going to go into, we had a Mother's Day contest last week, and we're going to just show you what we announced last week. And for those of you who missed it, this is what we do here on the show. Periodically, we have a lot of great contests where you can win money. We gave a $25 Visa gift certificate out a couple of weeks ago. Last week, we had a contest for Mother's Day to name some songs. We have a beautiful gift basket that we're going to tell you about. But this is a little... bit about
what we
did with
it. I got a surprise for you.
Okay, well, let's run this and we're going to get back to it.
Special contest giveaway. Yes, you know it's almost Mother's Day, so we're having a special Mother's Day giveaway. We're giving a beautiful gift basket by St. James Cosmetics. Now, all you have to do to enter is name 10 songs that have the word either mama or mother in it. Now, you have to identify three things: the title, the artist, and the year that it was recorded. Okay? Now, we will announce the winner on our show next Friday, which is May 10th. So, what we're going to do is choose the winner on May 8th. So, the deadline will end on May 8th. So, we can ship the prize to you next day. Now, all you have to do if you missed this announcement is go to our website, which is www.itsafamilyaffair.biz, like showbiz, B-I-Z. And we'll give you instructions on what to do and give you these clues all over again. So watch the show. If you missed it now, you can watch it all the time, anywhere, anyway, on YouTube, on RMC YouTube, okay? But go to our website and we'll give you all the information. So don't delay. Get in right now. Come on down. Hey, I'm here with my girl, Patricia St. James, with St. James Cosmetics. Hey, I love St. James Cosmetics. I use it. It's beautiful, darling. But she's going to give away a basket, and she's going to tell you a little bit about the products. Take it away.
Okay, thank you so much, Kathleen. Yes, I am Patricia St. James, and I am the owner of St. James Cosmetics. So today's special is a beautiful gift basket for Mother's Day. And remember, you must enter the contest. So let me tell you a little bit about my skincare line. It's as natural products can possibly be. We do no animal testing, and I do believe before you go into this line, you must put this first. So skincare is very, very important to me because it's important to keep your skin nice and healthy before you apply beautiful cosmetics. And my products for my cosmetic line is all, once again, natural. And when I say natural, you have to put certain ingredients so that it can look beautiful on your skin. So I'm going to be giving away a beautiful, beautiful gift basket for Mother's Day. So once again, you must enter the contest. And if you're interested in ordering any of these beautiful products, please go to my website and it will be shown on the screen later. Thank you so much and have fun. And don't forget, this is a Mother's Day special with a beautiful basket that your mother will absolutely love. And that's a promise. Thank you.
That's right. So we do have a winner. We had a lot of entries, and we want to thank everybody for participating in this contest. All you had to do was to go online and look up, hey, Mother's Day songs with Mama or Mother, and it's very simple. We tried to make the contest easy enough for everybody, but the main fact is we'd like to have everybody involved and interested in being in the contest. And so this is, like I said, one of many, but right now I'm going to allow Narayana, you there? You have the name of the winner. Tell us a little bit about who won and what have you. Narayana?
Okay. It's good. It's my pleasure. And the winner of the Mother's Day St. James Cosmetic Gift Basket is, what is that? Thomasina Bradley.
What?
For real?
That's random.
That's my mama. Oh, my God.
That's your mama.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Congratulations, Auntie Tommy. Woo!
From South Carolina, huh?
She's actually in North
Carolina. Oh, North Carolina? She's way back east jumping up.
Dang.
That's good.
Yeah, that is random.
Yeah, he's in North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Dang.
That's seriously random, people, because we had at least 40, 50 people. With the right answers.
She won.
But you know, you know what we did? I took all the people who had the correct answers, what we did, and put their names in a little basket. And I had my handsome, fine, beautiful little 5-year-old nephew, my little baby. Where's my boy? King Yari. Here's King Yari. King Yari, I had him draw the name and find out who the winner is. Yeah, it's a little bright. And he looks like a girl with all that long hair.
His hair is so long.
How come you don't have his clothes on? What's up with that?
Long hair. But he chose the winner randomly, and it just happened to be my former sister-in-law, Thomasina. And we want to congratulate Tommy. We'll get the basket to her from St. James Cosmetics. It's a beautiful basket. But that's little King Yari. There's my boy. That's my baby, King Yari. Look at him.
That's good.
He did the drawing. That's our little baby. So anyway, we're going to continue on with the show here. And, hey, just make sure you all get in the next contest.
That is very exclusive.
So, like I said, we're talking about your mothers. Mothers are our mamas. And, you know, it's just
one
a very...
picture of my baby. Nobody cares.
Yeah, here's another picture of King Yari. Let's show King again. Show King. Hold it on, King. Mm-hmm. It's a very sentimental time of the year for a lot of people because, you know, like my mother-in-law, I must say, Francine Redd. I got to give a shout-out. She passed away a couple of years ago.
Yeah. Francine. Love you, baby.
Yeah.
Special kind of woman. Yeah. Special.
Tell us a little bit about your mother, Terrence.
She would do any and everything for me, for her children. She was a wonderful woman. She had good principles, good values, believed in family and making it right. Mm-hmm. She was very, very good. Yep. Made good friends, and she spoke it like it was.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she did speak it like it was.
I'll
like
never forget that airline flight, that last event. She spoke it like it was.
Let me say this about that. You know what? Now Terrence is being a little... You know,
I got some nice memories too.
Well, let me say something about Francine Redd. I wish I started to bring her photo here. Maybe we'll get a chance to interject it when the show's finished and we go to post editing. But Francine Redd, that was my girl. I can relate to her a lot, and I think Terrence and his sister Dawn Howard, who's a wonderful sister-in-law, me and Francine we could relate. Let me say this. We would have a few little cocktails and drinks together. Mama Redd, as sweet as she was like on the other side. Boy, she would tell you what it was like and tell you how it was. We took Mama Redd to on a vacation in Orlando, Florida. And we were in the airplane. Mama Redd was sitting beside me. And there was some young ladies behind us. And this girl kept putting her feet. Took her shoes off, put her feet in between the seat with her feet and toes hanging on the side.
Nasty smelling feet.
Mama Redd looked at it and everything and said, told her once or twice, could you please, you know, excuse me, can you move your feet? You know, so she did that. She moved her feet and then did it again. This girl, she didn't know what she was getting involved in. So Mother Redd asked her one more time. The girl said, well, you know what? I can put my feet up here if I want it. She said, no, you can't. You better not. And it just happened to be a Filipino girl. She said, you know what? Why don't you go home and eat your dog?
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. I don't think I ever heard this shit. He said, go home and eat your dog.
That was the first.
I was sitting next to her.
That's what they do. They eat their dogs.
Don't say
dog.
I cracked up. I laughed for the whole damn flight. We had about 4 or 5 hours. Every time I look back, every time I look at Mama Redd, we was having our cocktail sipping and thinking about that shit. It was so funny.
I laughed like 2 minutes later. Like, it took me a minute.
Ooh, that's
priceless. How about an energy tip for everybody out there hanging with us?
Okay, let's do that. Let's
try that.
Okay.
We'll bring that up in a minute. In fact, I got something even better. Let's do a Mother's Day surprise. Let's slip one in on you.
Oh, really?
It's time for you to just know, baby.
Again.
You're the mother of children. I want you to read that.
Man, you guys
and
are gonna
totally
make me
be
cry.
Surprised.
You really
Come on.
Going to make me cry on camera live.
The
camera.
World needs to know
it's
what's
hard
in
to
that.
Surprise me.
Come
okay.
on, baby.
Oh my God.
Surprise you and wipe these damn little
I can see
on.
No.
Ooh, it's foggy.
I can see it. It's hard to surprise me.
No. We can get you anytime
All
we
right.
want.
Oh, okay. Here we go.
We can cut that diva stuff down to the knees. I'll show you brothers out there how to do that if you want. But anyway, let's keep going, baby.
A Mother's Day statement.
This is a Mother's Day statement.
Well, am I supposed to read this?
Yeah, read that real quick.
To a wonderful mother, wife, friend, entrepreneur, and not to forget my golf buddy. Aww. Hand in hand, we walk together. God's grace warms us from above. As him, I thank each day I wake for blessing me with all your love. You're the sunshine in my morning, and the bird that sings my song. In this life, when I am troubled, it's you who keeps me strong. You're the wind beneath my wings as this ego takes to flight. Mm-hmm. You're the stars that brighten up my sky in the darkness of the night. You're the mother of my children and the air that gives me life. My trusted friend of all, my heart, my soul, my wife. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it, Terrence.
That's right, baby.
That is so sweet.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh my God, I love it. Oh my God, this is precious. This is
good stuff.
Oh my God, hold on. I have got to see what's in here. Oh my God, you guys. Oh.
Yes, Auntie, I wish I was there.
I know.
I love for you, baby.
Let's see. Oh. What is it? Ooh.
You are appreciated.
Oh my God.
Turn it around.
Okay, I'm going to show it to the camera here. Ooh, oh, my God. Coco Chanel, baby. Woo!
Oh, the close-up.
Oh, let's see. I do my little prices right, little showing. Oh, my God. Coco Chanel.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's the bomb.
God.
Is that the oil?
This
is it, baby.
Oh, yeah, that's the body oil, the dry body oil.
We're going to have plans, and
actually,
I'm going to put this on.
Here.
Nothing like having a good, sweet-smelling wife,
exactly,
huh?
Exactly what it is.
They work me so hard, I can rarely take a shower.
Love
Damn.
That.
Okay.
Ooh, I'm trying. Now, I can borrow some.
Now that comes right into energy tips. I'm trying to save water because I'm thinking, thinking. Thank you, Narayana. Thank you, husband. Thank you, everybody. Oh, my God. Okay.
Oh, wait.
Energy tip.
No, he didn't. What? Yeah. Mm-mm. Just trying to help my friend clean up in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord.
Okay. This is Big T's Energy Tips. I've come into a home to show you real time and take energy saving to the next level. Let's go see what happens in homes at the kitchen sink. As you can see, this is one of the owner's girlfriends, just running water, wasting away energy. It's time for Big T to step in and fix it for him. Excuse me, ma'am. We're here trying to fix the problem for homeowners saving energy.
Yeah.
Would you please move out the way so I can fix this sink and save some money for this energy? This is total waste, and we don't allow that at Spectrum Contractors. Thank you. Move.
Good. You
so now you can see right here, waste. Girlfriends on the phone, parties, people just running the water. Waste. Ask the husbands out there, does this happen to you? Well, right now, I'm letting you know, if you cut that water off between the waste and pay attention at the sink, that's another fine for energy savings. So this is Terrence bringing you another Big T Energy Tip. Thank you.
Hey there.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Good music.
So you know what? I don't know who that lady was, but... Think about the next time you let your girlfriends help you run water in your kitchen. That's happened to me before during a party. They're thinking they're being helpful. They just running that water. But you have to really conserve water because you know what? I found out, and thank God my husband has really brought it to our attention at the house. When you get water coming out, you have to pay for the water going out as well. So you're paying for it two times. So be thinking about that water and people flushing toilets coming in your house. Let them take two times, two peas, one flush. Okay? Thank you.
You're on the right track, family.
You know
just keep it
right.
Up. We'll
now,
get it.
One poo-poo per flush, but two pee-pees per flush will work just fine.
If it's yellow, let it mellow. If it's brown, flush it down.
There you go. That's it, baby. I knew we taught you right, my baby.
Oh, we have all surprises for you today as well. So, you know, here you go.
What? Come around.
Which mine came first that epic, you know, cocoa perfume.
Well, honey, I don't...
Hey, this is something for me, so...
Okay, here, sit down. Kneel down, so I want you in my shot. Oh, man, this is... Oh, my God. I tell you, I'm totally surprised, people.
And it's not even Sunday yet.
I know. And yeah. I'm Sunday, I am going. I said I want it for Mother's Day. Maybe go to an early brunch, but I want to stay in bed all day and watch all my DVR shows I've been missing out on.
Dude, we don't have to take you nowhere. No, we can just have a brunch in bed.
Cheyenne. Brunch in bed. Yeah.
I asked her, did she want to go see the number one movie? Right, Iron Man 3. No, she'd rather stay in bed and watch her movie.
Yeah. Well, we're going to see Iron Man 3 at the SAG Screen Actors Guild movie that we paid for the whole year in the end of this month. Let me see what my baby bought me. Oh, ooh, red nice. For Mrs. Woo! Red.
Safari.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, baby, I hope this fits my big old.
I like that.
Safari.
Nice.
You mean busting out the button.
Look at that.
It says
I'm wearing this on the next show, so look out for it. Thank you, my love.
Nice.
Well, and I am a medium. A lot of people think because I'm big bone, I ain't, you know,
myth.
I wear a bit. No, but I do wear a medium, and I do. Thank you, sweetie.
Medium stretch.
A medium stretch, yes.
Like I'd like to get a quick little thank and shout out to Auntie Shimmy, Cousin Shimmy, happy Mother's Day, and Auntie Thomasina. She said, yes, she is listening, and she said, thank you all very much. She heard that she won. She's actually watching alongside with Shimmy. So, hi. Love you.
Oh, look at this from my this is really strange.
Happy Mother's Day.
Oh my God,
mothers.
Look at this.
That is so
nice.
Yep. Oh man, this is like Hollywood movie scenes and stuff.
Yeah,
and cinema.
Fashion.
A little stretch action, huh?
Nice.
Oh, okay. Man, look at that. I don't know if you can see it.
Oh, since we're almost done, I have one.
Thank
more.
You, sweetie. Come here.
I have one more hat to pull out the bag, too.
I love my babies. Thank you so much. There I'm very happy, very fortunate. You know, God has been blessing us all along, especially with my family. We had some crises and ups and downs last year, people, I have to tell you. But you know what? You have to go through it to get to it. And God has been good to us. We've been through some ups and downs with our marriage and life and time. And children have been pretty good for the most part. We've been real blessed, you know.
Surprise! We're popping bottles. I got you a little champagne. And I got big tea, a bottle of non-alcoholic beverage.
Martinelli's for Terrence. Here you go. He doesn't drink. He is the designated driver. Oh, baby.
And everybody needs something sweet.
Mama Napa.
So I got you some New York style chocolate tuxedo cheesecake.
Wow, you got
it. It might still be frozen, and some strawberry swirl. It might still be frozen,
well,
but
thank you, Cheyenne.
It's a little Mother's Day early pre-dessert because every mother deserves something sweet. Chocolate covered strawberries was not on the menu today, so
this is fine. This is fantastic. all of this will be divulged Sunday while I'm laying in my bed. All I do.
No, we're gonna open one of those. Now.
All I require
you
is
open one
two
now?
Meals, brunch, breakfast, and a dinner. I'm gonna have my champagne.
I got that. Don't trip.
I'm gonna have coffee. I want to stay awake. I want to go to sleep. No kids. No babies. No nothing. I'm gonna watch the golf tournament. The Players. It's the Sunday with Tiger Woods. He's in it doing well.
Don't you want to go out and play some golf?
I did want to go out and play golf, but right now I'd rather stay in and watch. You know, I'm busy every day doing something. Helping my grandbaby get up to go to school, get on the bus. I love him dearly. The bus is coming.
The bus is coming.
Yeah, but
the bus is coming.
G-Ma is going, and G-Ma is going to lay in that bed and just in comfort. I think that is a wonderful day, wonderful time.
I think now would be a good time for a random tip. Okay. I should start my own book of tips.
Go ahead.
So a good tip in order to open a bottle that requires a cap, you can use anything. This is simply my mascara, and you're going to do a little hook, and
there you go.
Except your skirt, never that.
Your mascara, how'd you do that?
Wow,
easy.
But you know what?
How's the tip, T? Is it still alive?
Next week, I'm shaking it up with Cheyenne.
Yeah. I can do the same exact thing. You can do it.
I can do it. You know what? I used to be with the singing group, the Love Machine, back in the day when we traveled all over the world, abroad, everywhere, and we would get bottles from various places and have. You know, a problem having a bottle opener with us when we traveled. So we would go to the door jam. You know, you could do it at the door jam.
Pop it.
And pop it right there at the door jam.
You would hit it down? Because you can do it like that on the table.
Or hit it down, yes.
Those are called hood techniques.
Yes, we had some hood techniques, especially trying to open up that wine bottle. You know, when you have to put the cork down inside and you're desperate.
Give another cut.
And you're pounding that cork down in instead of being able to take it out because you don't have a corkscrew. But that's called improvising oily, okay? We improvise. That's what we do, all right? But this is just like Mama Red used to say, this is choice.
So this is all about mothers.
Let's get a family toast, everyone.
There's a family toast. Narayan?
Here's to all the mothers.
Narayan, are you toasting?
Pick up your glass.
Yeah, I'm here.
Where's the camera? Can I get
toast.
Okay, everybody.
Thank you. Here's to our family. We're drinking Martinelli's right now. However,
do one more.
Oh, we do have to give one shout out to Larry Flash Jenkins. Today is Larry's birthday.
Happy birthday, Larry.
Happy birthday, Larry Jenkins. He used to be on White Shadow, Larry Jenkins. He's an actor. He's a director. And presently, he and my husband are working together on a movie project and looking for funding. I think they have the funding. But if anybody out there is interested, there's a lot of good projects going on. Of course, I have to be in it. Okay. Since they did not put me in the other Friday coming up.
Oh, yeah, that's next week's topic, because we could talk a whole show
I believe Ice Cube is whitewashed right now.
Oh,
I really think he is.
Even my other husband, little Tony Cox, I talked to him last night. He and I keep in contact, Tony Cox, my husband from Friday, and he says people are asking him, did you hear the rumor about Friday, the last Friday being shot or filmed and what have you, and he hasn't heard anything from them. I said, you know what, they know where to find us.
Well,
so Tony and I
too.
We have to do our own little Mr. and Mrs. Parker, you know, just like Mr. and Mrs. Smith. How about that? Wouldn't that be awesome? Like Brad Pitt and Angelina. Okay, Tony and Kathleen.
Not a bad idea.
Not a bad idea.
That would be,
Producers, directors, hello.
Yeah, we need
we have to write it ourselves sometimes in this industry to make sure that we are, well represented.
Well, I think the world's going to be seeing you a lot soon because you're coming out with your book. You're going to be around. You're going to be on TV shows.
Backstage at The Price is Right.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
Memoirs of a Barker's Beauty. And the T-shirts are coming out, too. I do have Miss Parker T-shirts. We will all be sporting the Miss Parker T-shirts. And we're very excited about this show in particular. I want to thank RMC On Air Live coming to you. And Poetess, our
thank
girl
you.
Here. And everybody who's made this special, and of course, our sponsors, Shambord, and Spectrum Contractors and Developers.
That's right.
It's been a wonderful ride. This is our sixth show. We've got our site, www.itsafamilyaffair.biz, like showbiz, because we is in showbiz now. And through the wonderful technical advancements in what's happening with
Narayan, are you on there?
Yeah, we're here, Narayan.
Oh yeah, Narayan.
What you got to say, nephew? We're getting ready to log off, baby. What you have to say?
I just want to say thanks for everybody for tuning in. We are going to be having other nice, beautiful things coming your way. I'm glad that your family is my family and my family is your family to enjoy this beautiful array of beauty. Thank you.
You're welcome, nephew. And without any further ado, we're going to take it back to the Mother's Day song that we all love and adore.
Happy Mother's Day,
Happy
everyone.
Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy
Mother's Day.
Have something
nice. Happy Mother.
Bye. something that you can't describe.